Living organisms have huge reproductive potential. Yet in most cases, populations do not grow exponentially. Instead, they are limited by the constraints of the environment and its carrying capacity. Natural or wild populations are limited by the availability of food as these pups battle for positions to nurse on their mother's milk. But the struggle goes on throughout life. The battle for survival also includes escaping predators. With the fittest or the best adapted organisms being able to escape the clutches of the predator. The struggle extends itself to climatic conditions like harsh cold. And here, these plants are in a struggle for light, space, and nutrients. But this competition or struggle for existence is not a fair one because there is genetic variation which can be continuous, showing a smooth movement from one extreme to the next with respect to a particular trait like skin color, or it can be discontinuous with distinct types or varieties of a particular trait. This variety results from independent assortment and segregation in meiosis. And it results from crossing over in meiosis. Each gamete or sex cell that is formed is unique, and fertilization is random. But in addition to these built-in forces of variation, nature has its own surprise packet. Coming out of genetic mutation, you could get favorable traits or unfavorable traits. The favored ones have the potential to make significant changes in populations. Sometimes it can open entirely new areas for the new types to colonize, as a favorable mutation may allow a group of individuals to move into a slightly different type of habitat or into a new niche. But for any of these favored traits to be able to contribute to the improvement of a species population, it is essential that individuals cross the final hurdle in the struggle for existence, and that they're able to find a mate to reproduce. And when they reproduce, their offspring must be able to reproduce. And it is only in this way that the fruits of the struggle provide the seeds of the next generation. So important is this aspect of the struggle for existence that many species have evolved elaborate displays and mating rituals designed to ensure successful reproduction and to ensure the safe delivery of their genetic package to the future generations. This type of descent with modification, summarized here, is more popularly known as the theory of evolution. Evolution by natural selection. The most powerful piece of evidence in support of this descent with modification, or evolution by natural selection, is the fossil record. Here, in this artist's recreation of the evolution of Ecus ferus, Przewalski's horse, you can see the smooth gradation over time, the descent with modification. Recreations of this kind and others are made possible because of the stories in the rocks, the fossil record. Here at the Grand Canyon in Arizona, the Colorado River winds its way from an elevation of 1,000 meters at Lee's Ferry, some 400 kilometers, to Lake Mead, which is just 400 meters above sea level. As the river cuts through the canyon, it exposes the rock that's able to take us back in time, cutting through some 1.7 billion years of geologic and paleontologic history. Every few kilometers reveals another episode in the stages of descent with modification. Improvement in one type over time is one thing. How can one species give rise to others while at the same time continuing itself to exist? This can happen when populations are isolated and subjected to different environmental conditions. If this isolation is geographic and brought about by volcanic eruptions, earth movements, or floods, then it's referred to as allopatric speciation. The marine iguanas of the Galapagos provides a classic example of allopatric speciation.